Sound check, sound check. Just kidding. Nervous because I'm not good at recording videos, posting videos of myself talking, especially when it comes to a serious matter, which I'm about to. Thinking to share this for a while. And hoping that this may help someone. This message goes to people struggling with mental illness, suicidal ideations, like myself. Back in May last year, I was in a mental home inpatient treatment for over a month, struggling with severe anxiety, severe depression, and suicidal ideation. While I was there, I came across this Arabic saying: you want to die, then throw yourself in the ocean, and you'll find yourself swimming to survive. And it's not that you want to kill yourself. Is that you want to kill something inside of you, in you, that you don't like. You hear the birds? Okay, back to it. The program was amazing, giving us all these resources that we can look for information and we can learn from, right? To recover from mental illness. So it was a long process because I think before I even went to this home, I started listening to motivational and inspiring videos and positive and mental health, but it wasn't doing anything. It took some time, all right? But I understood that every information you give your brain will believe it. So that is something that there's been studies, right? That, well, that's a different topic. But let me go back to what I wanted to share. If you are struggling with a suicidal thought, you might want to try this. It helped me. It helps me every time. And I'm not going to say that 100% do it all the time. But I was going to curse. I'm so sorry. I curse a lot. Thinking about that saying over and over again, every single day for hours. And I wanted to find a way to believe it. At this point, I heard it, but I didn't really connect fully with it. I didn't believe it, right? But it was an idle thought. You say, how can I put it to work? How can I practice it in a practical, real life, now, here, now, right? Way. And then I thought, what is something that I do that I do very carefully? And I want to be curious, why am I careful? And one thing that I do very carefully is driving. I make my mistakes, like everybody, when it comes to driving. And I realize that I always drive very careful. My kids sometimes tell me that I drive like a grandma. Don't drive like a grandma. I'm just very careful. I start questioning why. Why is it that I drive so carefully, right? And then I said, okay, I drive carefully because I don't want to get into a car accident. I don't want to hit someone. I don't want to crash. Why do I don't want to crash? Well, I realized that I wanted to come back home safely and alive. Why do I want to come home safely and alive? Well, and it's because in reality, I do value my life, right? I don't want to kill myself. And it's not that I want to kill myself, but I want to kill a lot of things that don't serve me, and that I hurt my mental health, and that I'm not happy with. So that grounds me and brings me back to my hopes, my dreams, good things that I have in life. I have a lot of things to be grateful for. My vision becomes blurry sometimes, but when I bring myself back, I'm able to see again all of those blessings. One thing primarily is like I want to see my kids grow. I want them to be happy. I want them to learn to be happy. Be driving for you like it is for me, but it is something different. Is it sewing? Is it cooking? What is it that you do carefully? And remember to be kind to yourself and to others, because we're all struggling with something different things, but we're all struggling, and life is hard. But when we find kindness and practice it to ourselves, I think we can be more kind to others, and sometimes other people need some kindness. An act of kindness can change someone's whole day. So you're not alone. You're not alone. But we can find each other to help each other. So if you guys want information about the mental home facility that I was in, I'm happy to share that with you. Whatever has been helping me in my healing journey, I'm here, happy to share my story. I'm still in the process of healing. I have my good days, my bad days, and actually, like, a healing journey is like a lifetime journey, right? But we can find support, and having support is very important. It's been very important to me. I'm stubborn sometimes. I forget about that support, and I think I can do it on my own, and then I realize that, you know, sometimes I need to find an extra push, a little help. Mindset, positive mindset, right? It's hard to be positive at all times and every day. But even if you don't believe it in that moment, keep saying that to your brain. Keep saying how blessed you are, how intelligent, beautiful you are. And our brain is gonna remember those words and be like, oh, wait a minute, yes, I'm all of that. And that's all for today. Take care.